The Human Performance Lab features a new piece of equipment, the GAITRite, purchased jointly by Health Sciences, Sanders Brown Center on Aging, and Neurosurgery. A few of these researchers detail the potential impact of the GAITRite.
One of the main areas of focus of our research is with patients with Parkinson's disease. And one of the things that we're very interested in is how deep brain stimulation can improve patients and their mobility from a perspective of when we implant electrodes and treat our patients, what can we do better? How can we get a better outcome? This laboratory really gives us an opportunity to dig into the details and really objectively measure their movement and be able to track progress.
This apparatus we'd heard about from colleagues at the University of California at Irvine, who is kind of our sister project in following people with Down syndrome who are aging. What we plan to do in the future, and this is the first step, which we're very, very excited about, is to measure gait changes in our cohort of people with Down syndrome who are getting older, compare those to people in California who are also aging, combine these data in a multi-center study. So almost everybody with Down syndrome around the age of 40 has full-blown Alzheimer's in their brains. So we're hoping that the GAITRite instrumentation is going to help us dissociate maybe who is going to develop dementia or who is going to stay healthy as they get older.
They come see us every year so we can get some fairly extensive measurements on practical brain functioning as well as how their brain is put together. So we can see that change over time. And what we're finding out is that it's possible that the motor system within the brain that's regulated by white matter may not be communicating with itself as effectively to regulate how that person actually moves in space in their own environment. So hopefully we can use that information to time the onset of treatment. If you have an individual who doesn't feel as confident in their gait, they are less likely to go out, socialize, be active in their community because they don't feel as confident that they're going to be able to do that without potential injury. So then if we can examine how that functioning is actually occurring for them, that allows us to be much more targeted in helping them function in the way that they would like to for much longer.